Today I am going to discuss you regarding mucormycosis or black fungus. Nowadays we have seen many news. Post-COVID patients, some of the post-COVID patients had this disease. So let me discuss what is mucormycosis or black fungus. So from the name itself, mucormycosis means it is a mucor species which causes this fungal infection. So it is called mucormycosis. You know that it is usually seen in wet areas. That means wet soil, decayed vegetables and fruits and some cow dungs, those area which is what not sanitized properly. So these areas are at high risk of developing what? This infection. And the area where the unsanitized oxygen pipelines are there the fungus may be grown. So these areas are at high risk of developing what? Fungal infection. You know, normally this fungus is grown everywhere surrounding us, but those who are having low immune system, they are at high risk of developing this infection. So we can discuss which category patients are at high risk of developing this infection. So those who are immunocompromised means those who have taking some immunosuppressants drug, or those who have undergone organ transplantation, or they are at high risk of developing this infection. You know, these patients, the immunity is very low, so small amount of organism is more than enough to infect them and will cause many severe symptoms in the patient. And secondly, the patient with a diabetic ketoacidosis. In diabetic ketoacidosis also, the patients with a DK, their immune system is very low. That means there is a process which is called phagocytosis. The phagocytosis process is very, very low. What is phagocytosis? Phagocytosis is the process where our antibodies will kill the virus or microorganism which is entering in our body. This process is very low in the diabetic ketoacidosis patient. So this patient is also at high risk of developing this fungal infection. And thirdly, those who are cancer patients. These cancer patients are having what? Low immune system. They are also at high risk of developing this infection. And those who are using steroid for any other disease conditions or overuse of steroids. Now every steroid is an immunosuppressant. So the immunity become very low and this fungus will attack the body and it will cause many serious disorders in the body. Okay, so these patients are at high risk of developing what? This disease, mucormycosis or black fungus. So let me discuss which areas this disease is affecting. So first of all, it is what? A rhinocerebral area. Rhinocerebral area means it affects this area, sinus and cerebral area. And the patient may have what? Nasal stuffiness, nasal congestion, uneasiness while breathing. And the patient may also have breathing difficulty and swelling around the face. And if it is involving the gastrointestinal tract, the patient may have enterocolitis, severe diarrhea and all, and many other GI symptoms, gastrointestinal symptoms. And if it is involving in pulmonary area, that means lungs, the patient may have what? Severe breathing difficulty, and sometimes if it is left untreated, it can lead to respiratory arrest. And thirdly, the patient may also have, if it is affecting what? Cutaneous area. Cutaneous means skin. Some patients, through the wound or cut, these fungus will be transmitted. So it will cause what? Many problems in that area. There will be what? Redness and dryness, and many other symptoms will be there. And disseminated means if this fungus spread to the blood, it will involve into the major organs like brain, eyes and all, and which will lead to vision loss and many other symptoms like meningitis, encephalitis and all. So these areas are affected with this fungal infection. So let me discuss about the treatment. Normally we can treat it with antifungal drugs like amphotericin B, and surgery to remove which area it is involved, fungus is involved, that area we can take by surgery, we can remove by surgery. And the important thing is that the main treatment, you want to treat the exact cause of the disease. If this disease occurs because of overuse of steroids, you want to reduce the steroid use. And another main thing is control the blood sugar in the body and boost up the immune system in the body. So this is the main treatment you want to give for this patient, and other symptomatic treatments. And what are the best way to prevent this mucormycosis or black fungus? You want to avoid overuse of steroids. There are some people, those who are taking steroids without prescriptions and all. So don't do that. If you are using overuse of steroids, it will lead to what? Low immunity, and they are at high risk of developing this infection. Especially after COVID-19 and all, the virus, this COVID-19 virus, it attacks the immune system, and the immune system is very low, and they are on steroids means again the immune system become very, very low. So they are at high risk of developing this infection. And so please be careful while using the steroids. Without doctor's order, we should not take steroids. And control the blood sugar is very important. It will also prevent what? Black fungus or this mucormycosis. I hope that everyone understood what is mucormycosis or black fungus. See you all with another video. Thank you.